So in terms of today, I suppose we're talking all about supply chain and about resilience. So I head up the supply chain resilience and development team here in Invest Northern Ireland. And, you know, we're delighted to host this event here today. I think what I want to do is give you a bit of a brief overview in terms of what the service is. Well, first of all, talk a little bit about the background, how we arrived at that, and take you through just who we are, what we do, and how you can get support. And as Melanie says, there'll be an opportunity for questions afterwards. So, a little bit of background in terms of our side. So, as was already mentioned this morning, we've talked about, you know, the climate and what is all the changes and turbulence that has came in the world over the last number of years through COVID, through EU exit, through in terms of container ships getting stuck, as Mark was alluding to earlier, and some of the more recent geopolitical situations. So, these have all led to increased emphasis on the supply chain. And I suppose when we start to look at the supply chain, you know, the impacts of that in terms of by focusing on it, minimizing stock helps to reduce your working capital, so helps from a financial standpoint. Material availability, if you don't have the materials, it has a big impact on the efficiency of your organization. And the third one in terms of, you know, controlling those material costs, so controlling the input costs into your business. That has an also a big impact on the overall business profitability. And as I suppose mentioned this morning, the environmental side in terms of that scope, 1, 2, and 3 emissions as well. So all that coupled with the fact that typically over 50% of the cost of sales in your business will be associated with supply chain. I was speaking to a company last week and they were telling me, you know, up to 80% can be involved. So that all put increased emphasis on actually the supply chain and starting to focus on that. So in context of that background, we set up the Supply Chain Resilience and Development Service, or Supply Chain Solutions, as we refer to it now, in terms of, you know, just simplifying what that message is. So, who we are? We're very much a, you know, an industry group of people. So in terms of the team, there's a team of 9 who are wearing yellow lanyards about the facility here today. So everybody in the team comes from that sort of blue chip multinational background. So that is helping to bring credibility and knowledge and experience when we're working with companies and offering you that practical advice. And I think that's really important. So, you know, from an Invest NI standpoint, we provide financial support, but we also have this direct expertise in terms of expert, you know, technical advice that's there. But I think another part of it when we're looking at this, a lot of the team have been there and felt the pain. So we've got that skill set to help to provide that strategic supply chain focus. So hopefully that makes sense. Now, what we do in terms of what we look at, I guess we are looking at the key driver for us is a structured 3-step process where we start to look at the business in terms of how do you help to develop your supply chain function to enhance the value, reduce the risk, and ultimately improve the competitiveness that you get through your supply chain activities. And that's all about driving productivity in organizations. So when we're actually engaging with companies, these are some of the areas that we're looking at. And I'm not going to go through this in detail here. You know, you can talk to myself or one of the team you want to find out more. But I suppose, very simply, risk plays a key part, helping you to understand what the risk is in the organizations. Looking at your sourcing practices, how do we do it better? How do we improve that supply chain and that procurement practices that you've got? And that leads into category management. Demand and supply, we heard that being referenced this morning a little bit earlier as well. And inventory, how often do you find you've got too much of one thing and you're out of something else? So helping you put better practices in place to actually optimize what your inventory would look like in that side. Relationship management, again, you know, Mark was alluding earlier just around, you know, how do you actually work with companies? Is it a transactional-based activity or is it more a partnership approach? So again, there's benefits as you work your way through that side, right on through to warehousing and logistics. So obviously, 2 other key areas be remiss not to mention as well, as we look further around and hence the topics this morning on digitization and sustainability. So we're putting increased emphasis on those as we look at going forward as well. All these, why are we doing it? They're all heading towards improving your financial position, you know, looking at improving the performance of your organization, you know, in terms of quality, delivery, financial performance. And ultimately, from an Invest Northern Ireland standpoint, we're looking at actually how can we help develop the ecosystem in Northern Ireland? How can we help deliver greater economic impact in the region? So, taking that another step, so if you engage with us, how does that work? It's all about helping you to build that resilience and capability in the organization. So we will look at providing a blend of sort of specialist industry advice and some financial support. So our first step, if you're working with, I know there's a number of companies in the room today that we're working with, but the first step is to go in and do a diagnostic. So that's all about scoping out, you know, understanding, you know, what you're doing from a supply chain, from a procurement perspective, and scoping out the improvement opportunities. And the main goal out of that discussion is really to help in identifying, prioritize what are the top supply chain improvement areas that you could focus on. Now, in some cases, it might just be practical advice and signposting, and then we've moved on. That's all you've needed. In other cases, we move on to what we call step two, which is really looking at delivery. So that is working on how we coach and mentor you through an improvement project. So once we've identified that, we're providing that coaching and mentoring to actually work our way through that. If as part of that process, we identify that there's a gap in the organization. So an example might be you've got, you know, there's two or three of us and we're all doing procurement, you know, we're all doing different things in terms of buying, but it's not tied together. And the business is at a stage of growth where you could benefit from a new dedicated supply chain management role, you know, to pull all that together. We will look at that, and we have the ability to actually put financial support in at the rate of up to 50% for the first 12 months' salary, capped at 25,000 in terms of support. So we provide this unique blend of being specialist advice led and then have the potential to have complementary financial support. And all that's supported by coaching and mentoring. But how does that also work? A big part of when we were setting up this is thinking about how do we change the mindset in organizations and how do we think about moving forward. So in lots of companies, if we look at the right-hand side here, you'll see that sort of traditional focus. And I suppose, you know, are things happening on an ad hoc basis? Is the structure right? Is the focus on, you know, lowest price? Do you have, you know, KPIs in place, et cetera? We find companies at different stages of maturity. And it was very interesting to see the poll this morning where a lot of people were talking, you know, when we look at the audience, over 50% of you know, attendees here today were saying you're at that sort of, haven't started your supply chain improvement journey, or you're at an early stage of it. And that, so you maybe see some of these type of practices. What we're looking at doing is shifting that to the more strategic focus. You've got some more of those structures and systems in place, and that helps to build resilience into your business. And I know Richard's going to talk later about resilience in terms of, you know, his view and experience around that, so we're looking forward to that. And when we're engaging with business, I guess we talk about sort of, there's a number of different areas we look at. We have webinars and tutorials available on our website, so if somebody just wants a little bit of bite-sized information, you can go to our webpage and actually click on that, and it'll take you straight through, and you can have a, you know, work through some areas there. When we're working with companies, we have a range of different supply chain masterclasses that are really focused around the areas that I talked about in the previous slide. So, for example, we were doing something last week on warehouse and inventory management as one of the examples on that. And obviously the one-to-one coaching and engagement. And today is an example of doing that outreach to create that more awareness and build, you know, that interest and focus in term, giving you knowledge and helping you to think about driving supply chain improvements. So ultimately, making sure my clicker is working okay there. So ultimately, what's that about? What we're trying to do is figure out how we can help you to create supply chains that are fit for the future, that are really focused on, you know, helping you to enable you to deliver your growth strategy. So if I was to ask businesses here, you know, how many businesses here have a 3 or a 5 year vision? Could I ask you to put your hands up? Okay, quite a few. How many here have a supply chain strategy that is actually aligned and delivering, enabling you to deliver that business growth strategy? Right. Yes, I was going to say there's always one or two, so a smaller number. So there's opportunities in things like that. Now, I'm not going to spend time on this. This is the technical detail in terms of who we engage with. The main point being is that if we're engaging on a one-to-one basis, it's about a company that has greater than £100,000 annual supply chain spend. That doesn't stop us having a conversation, offering you advice and support, signposting to websites and things like that. But that's the criteria. You can find out more on our webpage. So some example projects. And again, this is just to give you a flavor of some of the activities that we're doing. And it's not because we'll hear from companies after this presentation on some of their real life journeys, which will touch on some of these areas. But I suppose when we look across the team in some of the common areas, I already mentioned inventory has been a key thing. Cost saving, helping business to deliver tangible cost saving, that's really important. You know, that strategy area that I was alluding to, even in some cases, as we've worked with companies, they've actually reshored work back here to Northern Ireland. So that's fantastic for us as an economy, where business have been able to look at something, they're getting a better level of quality and service, and the total cost of ownership model has worked out to bring it back here. So that's great. And ultimately, you know, what we're looking at is how do we deliver those financial benefits to companies? So what's the impact to date? So this service was set up in 2021, so it's just coming up in 3 years in terms of our engagement. We've engaged with a lot of companies to date, but there's still lots of opportunities to engage with more. And this map is just giving you a flavor of the different companies that we've engaged with. In fact, we're close to 300 companies now that we've touched base with. So as you can see, we're working in all parts of Northern Ireland in terms of that engagement side. In terms of return on investment, we went through an independent appraisal last year. That independent appraisal highlighted that for the input cost in terms of the, you know, the economic return on investment, we were delivering in excess of 10 to 1 in terms of that return on investment based on what the cost was to, you know, to the public sector and what impact that was getting delivered. Also, part of that was touching on benchmarking analysis. So again, when you're going through an independent review, when you're looking at the program, the feedback was that, you know, we had set up something that was actually leading among international comparators. And I think that's great to hear that actually, because we had benchmarked against a lot of different things to make sure we filled a space that was valuable for that. And a lot of companies saw improvements in resilience. And last but not least, it's about, you know, delivering those financial benefits. So to date, you know, we've delivered in excess of 20 million impacts to companies in terms of business we're working with, in terms of helping you to actually drive those improvements in terms of that side of it. So it's about, again, that is all delivered through that coaching and mentoring and driving improvements. And at any point in time, our team would have over 50 active supply chain improvement projects with businesses. So there's plenty of activities going on, but that aside, lots of opportunities to engage more, and what I would hope to do as part of today is going to help you do that. Now, that happens to be one customer comments. You'll hear, you know, examples from others as we work our way through. I am hoping we're going to play a very short video here, which will just a video case study. If my technology works perfectly here, we'll see in the next push of the button. So this is an example to hear from three local companies, just a very short couple of minutes. So we'll play that now.
Malahan manufactures airport ground support equipment, including catering trucks, de-icers, passenger stairs, medical lifts for countries and airports all over the world. With ongoing global supply chain issues, we reached out to InvestNA regarding their supply chain resilience and development solution support to receive some guidance and expertise on how we can improve our procurement processes and the accuracy of our inventory. The first supply chain support project we undertook was improving the accuracy of inventory within our warehousing. The second project was based around purchase part cost reduction, working with our suppliers to try and get the best price possible for our parts. Through InvestNA support, we've been working directly with a supply chain advisor who has been providing one-to-one direct advice and coaching for our purchasing and warehousing teams. Working with our supply chain advisor, we've managed to improve the accuracy of our inventory and reduce the cost of our bought-in materials. We've seen a massive impact on our warehousing with a reduction in stock adjustments, which has had a direct effect on employee efficiency and the amount of inventory we hold. We would certainly recommend that other businesses engage with InvestNA and take advantage of the support that they offer.
SensorTech is a very young, innovative and productive company in the heart of Belfast. The types of development that we've undertaken in SensorTech is securing new business tools to provide our people with a good platform to be able to fill those supply chain functions. We're investing in dedicated resources in that department so that we can secure our supply chain for the 2, 3, 4, 5 years down the line. Invest and I have provided us with a dedicated resource in the supply chain resilience function. By working with the supply chain resilience team, this resource has been ever so helpful in helping us understand how to grow a supply chain management framework, how to build a sustainable business around the supply chain function. They've been really helping us mature our operations department completely. That's from the procurement side of things to warehousing to material handling. They've really removed a lot of wastage from our processes, helped us identify areas for saving, and helped us identify new areas of risk that we weren't aware of. I would absolutely recommend that any other business in this country should get in touch with InvestNI, especially to talk about supply chain resilience.
Norbev was established in 1919. We operate in Railway Street in Ballymena, manufacturing soft drinks. We applied for support for the supply chain solutions, having spoken to our client executive. We wanted to develop our supply chain function, manage the risks within the business and develop the opportunities. The initial project we undertook through the programme was to develop our supply chain resilience. We did that by developing a procurement strategy, which involved analysing our supplier spend. We analysed our shipping routes, our contracts that we had in place. We had one-to-one coaching with our advisor. It really lended a fresh pair of eyes. We were challenged at every step of our process, from planning through purchasing, production, distribution. I would strongly recommend the supply chain solution support to others. Norbev have developed excellent relationships with both their customers and their suppliers. The procurement strategy ensures that we have a cost-effective business and a long-term future. The support from InvestNI, yes, Norbev would still be here if we hadn't have availed of the support, but it certainly has given a more structured approach and a more confident approach.
So that's just giving you a little bit of a flavour of from some companies. You'll hear more in detail after this. So just to finish off this side, how do you get support? So if you scan the QR code that's here, or actually there should be one on each of the tables as well if you want to engage with us. We currently have an open call that you can just really effectively, it's open until the 22nd of March if you want to, you know, register through that in terms of an expression of interest. Or of course, if you're linking in with InvestNI in terms of speak to your client executive or client manager as part of that. Or you've got our team with yellow lanyards around here today as well. So speak to myself or one of the team if you want to have a, just, you know, look at anything any further. And ultimately, just to finish off, I suppose, what we're trying to do is ultimately supporting companies to develop their supply chains to support their growth ambitions. So this is all about how can we help you to realize your growth ambitions through better supply chain practices. So that's really everything from my side for now. I know we'll have an opportunity for Q&A afterwards. So thank you very much, everyone.